So family, that is the Arusha Declaration Monument, and we were just in the Declaration Museum, a lot of history. Family, and that's what we do, family. Roots and culture tour, hardcore.
Give you a nice little connection, family.
Get your grandma's house and burn a hole in your hand.
That's what I'm doing right now.
So Molly, is that security?
Hell no.
There's a security guard in the middle.
Why did they need security?
They just want, because this is the one of the famous monuments, they don't want people to misuse it. Some people will come and paint and do things, so they don't want things like that to happen.
She hooking it up out there. There's a lady doing weeding over there.
Yeah, she's working on it.
Yeah.
Yeah, the woman worked hard in Tanzania.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we're actually like side by side. It's not that we depends who is there first. And normally, like coffee harvesting, we use more women.
That's the same thing.
Like cleaning and weeding, we use more women because they have patience. They can do it slow.
That is funny.
If you send a boy there, he will just put together.
Yep.
So, picking coffee, when we go to Iflong Cultural Center, you'll see the coffee processing. Picking coffee, you need a proper person. You need a person with a patient with pick really red. Because if you pick semi-red or greenish, you lose the seed. You lose the value. You need to pick the really red one because the amount of sugar that is in the plant is very important for the quality of the coffee. One of our favorite exports.
Yes.
So it's always, they always need to be very careful of who is picking the coffee.
So what kind of coffee do I need to buy?
We normally grow a lot of Arabica, but in Zanzibar you can also get Robusta.
Robusta?
Yeah. So when the women are picking coffee, the men will carry the luggage. I mean the kilos of that coffee that's been picked from inside the farm to the outside where the tractor or the truck will be able to take it to the factory.
Besides coffee, what else?
We do...
Like what are you famous for?
Tea, coffee. In Zanzibar, we do a lot of gloves for export. They have recently started seaweed. Seaweed is also a big business.
Wow.
And again, who is doing the seaweed planting?
Women.
Women do everything.
Yeah, because they have time to think and decide if it's right or not. If you ask me to do, I just put the stick in there, the job is done. Anyway,
what is this building right here? It looks like something.
It's the Regional Commission Office.
It looks like a government building.
It's in Dar es
Salaam.
We're passing the Regional Commissioner Office. And next is coming is the. Wow. The next that is coming is Municipal Council Office of Arusha.
What is this place, Sistership?
This is the relation between the Municipal Council of Arusha and the Municipal Council of one of the cities in Germany. Yeah. So now we're coming to the German Boma as a natural history museum where we can also learn about the past. And in there, it's not a big space like where we was. The walls are at least 1 meter. So let's be careful of the enough. I don't know if they will have. Normally there's no good light. So, but when you go in there, slowly your eyes will get used to and you will be able to get the information. Actually here we need to do some logistics before we go in. So you just welcome into the yard. And then when everything is done, you can walk.
Perfect, yes. Keep on taking lots of beautiful photos.
fill up your account with photos.
Yeah, we're gonna load up some nice ones on Instagram.
And after here, we're going to the Maasai cultural market.
Okay. Where exchanging the money there?
No, before that.
No, honey.
So when we go to the cultural market?
No, she said exchange. No.
And get cards for our phone, so I can top up the coffee.
When we go into the Maasai market, when you're inside the fence, nobody will gonna take anything from you. It's very safe.
It is.
But be aware of people calling, like, come to my shop, buy from me, sister, friend.
Yeah, I feel
so is it better to shop here or better to shop in Zanzibar? Which one gives you the better distance?
If I say Zanzibar or here, I will be lying. You never know what you get here if you get in Zanzibar. And you never know if something that you get it here, it's same as what you get in Zanzibar. So
shop every day.
Go with your desire. If something very nice and you're not sure you got it in Zanzibar, I don't want you to get in Zanzibar and remember it.
And as soon as I cut this recording, I got a story to tell.
It's like
yeah, me too. I don't want to go on camera saying what I'm going to say.
Okay, go ahead. I'm off the camera. Go ahead.
So